I thought I was going to be an artist. I realized I was a theorist. I went to Baroda and I studied art history. And after that, I was like, okay, what next? So then I took up communications because I figured I'm not an academic type. And then I went to Mass Comm in Bombay, SCM. And then I started working as a journalist. I had a brief stint in cinema, which was completely, it didn't take off the ground. But that was a documentary film. We didn't get the funding, blah, blah. Then in journalism, I found that I was gravitating towards art because that's my natural, you know, whatever. That's what I know about. I've done art history. So, and then I started doing only exclusive journalism. I was initially doing fashion, you know, all the other stuff, food, music. Then I started zeroing on art. And then I started curating shows in 2008. I did my first show. And then my boss said, it's a kind of a clash of interests. So I quit journalism and I said, okay. Well, I want to be a full-time curator, so that's what I'm doing right now. But I continue to write for various publications and stuff. So I'm starting with my most recent project because I like that post. Mm-hmm. This is something we did in Hyderabad for this Krishna Kriti festival. So there were four curators, was Tato, Premji Shachari, and Faisal Khan, and there was me. Basically, it was looking at the premise, looking at technology and art. And within that premise, I sort of wanted to have a subset that looked at technology, art, and gender. Because gender is something which I find interesting and I've been working with it as an activist, as a writer as well. So these were my artists that I sort of zeroed in on. Baiju Parthan, Baptist Koyo, Hibzul Sheikh Kabir, Mukesh Sharma, Mahua Sen, Mohan Jangir, Prema Murthy, and Shilpa Gupta. So the idea was to basically bring feminist ideologies in conversation with technology. And I sort of went back and did some theory, excavated some theory, and kind of found that initially when technology sort of came into its being, it was not really gender sensitive. And it was not really, it was aimed at men, and it still is. A lot of it is still aimed at cis men. So I was sort of trying to unpack that premise. This is a shot of the gallery that finally, after 3-4 days of slogging, we managed to put this up. So this is Mohan's work. He is looking at this whole idea of trolling and the internet and photography. And what I found interesting about this image is that the man's identity is revealed, as in his body is sexualized, but the woman is sort of hidden. And also this whole play with the idea of the black man, who's extra, you know, sort of sexualized to the point where he's almost doesn't have an identity. So this work sort of looks at that. And if you go back one more slide, that's Mukesh Sharma's work over there. So he sort of is interested in ecology, and he reclaimed all these computers that have been dumped in piles and piles of e-waste. And he said, we can make planters out of them. So it was a kind of a humorous work. And he grew these money plants. And the money plant is a very middle class sort of motif of gathering wealth and prosperity. So unfortunately the money plants died. It was part of the, when we started off it was very nice and thriving, and then it sort of died, and it was also part of the work. So talking about the dying of the money plant and the computers was also talking about recyclability and the fact that we are killing our environment in so many words. So Mawa is working with the anonymous images on Facebook. And she does the reverse selfie. So selfie, you always want to make yourself look attractive, and you know, very often it's not exactly how you look. So she found these images that were slippages between that poised selfie, and a lot of them were headless, they were out of focus, they were doing something which was totally embarrassing. She collected these images and didn't bother about copyright or anything. She reproduced them and stuck them on these little boxes and created a kind of a city of images. This is Baptist Coelho's work. He talks about the concept of masculinity in a lot of his works, explores masculinity. This is called Cross-Legged, and he sort of does a four interview. He goes for a corporate job, dressed in jeans, and sits with his legs crossed. And then all these people are, you know, looking at him, this woman, that guy, he's like with a tie, very buttoned down, sort of like pant, shirt tucked into pant. And then the moment he uncrosses his legs and and starts looking at the magazine in this very masculine manner, he gets a call saying Baptist. He gets calling. So he sort of plays with gender a lot, and he talks about, as a man himself, putting himself in the skin of this character. This is Shilpa Gupta's work. It's called Half Widows. And she plays a game of hopscotch. This is Shilpa. She is performing herself, and she's drawn this pattern, and on this, well, this was a crazy work to mount. It was just insane. We had to build a wooden, plinth that was matching the aspect ratio of the projection. It was a very powerful work where she talks about this being in between states where you're not really married or you're not. And this is a thing which is peculiar to Kashmir. And she does a lot of work looking at the Kashmir border and looking at Kashmir. She works with a lot of borders. And so this work, it uses technology to talk about gender. It's not really aimed at technology itself, but it's using technology to talk about gender. This exhibition is called More Than Human, and I sort of wanted to explore where art is going in the age of photography. So I would say that, you know, there was a function where art used to sort of be used to record history. So you have the court paintings, you have the Mughal miniatures, you have even the company school paintings. All of this sort of, the challenge is now, okay, what is painting saying that photography is not? And you have digital technology, you have Photoshop, all these things. So painterly images, what are they saying? And I sort of looked at a lot of work, and I realized that a lot of people are exploring fantasy. They're talking about being larger than life, more than human. This is Birendra Pani's work, and he's quite a well-known artist. I'm sure you've heard his name. He's from Orissa, and he uses mythology in a manner that he uses mythology and current day issues, tying up together. So this is Garud and sitting on a very interestingly, the unfortunate image is cut, I apologize for that, but he's sitting on a tiger skin. So again, he's talking about ecology, he's talking about deities, what are the sub deities or the demigods in that sense. And this is Venus Topchop. He talks about identity of the Northeastern women, and he considers himself a feminist, so he's sort of appropriated that voice and talks about women's issues a lot. And this one is actually a series of several portraits. I do a disservice by showing only one. This is Ritu Kamath. She works a lot with, again, different media. This one is a work, you know, the kind of material you use for files, those folders, no? Okay. Kaatke, she has made these sort of media works. And again, it's talking about flight, it's talking about fantasy, it's talking about being more than human. Accessing those areas of your mind which is not really real in that sense. This is our team at Art Explore. So that's Pranav, the main guy who started it. Pink shirt, blue jacket is Aman. The one with the Nehru jacket is Pranav. He's the money bags. Uh-huh. Yeah. That's Vikram with the white shirt. He's the photographer. Anmol is our gallery assistant. And that's Tanvi. She was doing our marketing, but now she's been replaced. That's me, in case you didn't recognize. So this was our opening night, and we did More Than Human. Yeah, so we were looking at minimalism in photography, and we had this exhibition at India Habitat Center. Sorry. The idea was that in a circuit of images, we have so much happening in India. It's one of the places where, if you look at our photography, it's all about the sounds and the sights and the color. We have a history, whether it's Raghuvir Singh, whether it's even Raghuraya for that matter. So who are the people now who are looking at minimalism? Because it's something which, quote unquote, exists in the West. So the next project is, I did this show called Red Moon Songs at APJ Gallery, PT Paul Space. So, and I came up with this idea of Red Moon Songs, which looks at the cycles of the moon and sort of reclaiming this time when women go into their special time. Revisiting folk or the old traditions, and actually that's women are supposed to be most powerful at that time. And in modern day, it's considered to be a untouchable time. You have to sit on the ground, you can't go in the kitchen, you're not, oh my god, I got my period. And Anna is an artist from Poland. She's an amazing performance artist. She talks about a lot of issues, and here she's talking about this whole transformation of the self during that time. She starts off with nothing, just a black sort of a dress, very bland, and she covers herself in this white powder and becomes this sort of creature which is then very subversive. And then we have Himanshu. I don't know if you know Himanshu Verma's work, but he works a lot with gender. And he did a series of photographs as various characters. So here he's in a dance bar and sort of, and he's called the Sari Man. So he does sari with the beard also, which is very interesting, because he says, I'm not cross-dressing. I'm not a hijra. I am thinking that the sari can be a male garment as well. And why not? This is Sabrina Horsburn. Now she's a diaspora artist. And she lives in New York, and she talks about identity. And this work is shot in an old abandoned courthouse. Then I did this residency, art critic in residence at Coach, where we looked at dying forms of photography. Now we're working in a digital age. So I met these amazing guys, Edson Dias and Madhavan, and they built a camera obscura on site, and they took photographs of the kids who live in Khirki. They also built a do-it-yourself pinhole camera. These are the photographs taken by the kids who were working in Khirki. They took some amazing images. It was like, we just gave them cameras and said, go and document your life. And they took amazing images without even seeing what they were taking. Well, and they're like, hum log lekin mobile se kyun nahi le sakte? So we said, aap le lo, lekin ye bhi ek tarika hai. And then they were really excited about being in the dark room and everything. So then Mansi Bhatt was, she sort of offset the whole thing. Offset the whole thing by being a performance artist, and she used her photography to do a performance. And that time again Kashmir was raging issues, so she wore something and crawled through the streets of Khirki and all that. And these are just some projects I've done. Okay, this is another show that I wanted to talk about, Inside Out. This is, this is Aparna Jayakumar, Sanjeev Balsan, Maitha Ganpure and Pallavi Basu, and we talked about Inside Out being the space where, photography is sort of, this is a very strong image and I loved it because of that. Looking at, this is not in India, of course. This is abroad. And looking at how women sort of populate the public space and how men populate the public space, and whether the inside and the outside spaces can actually have a dialogue. Mm-hmm. And also the fact that there were two women photographers and two male photographers, and I wanted to sort of explore that whether, being a woman photographer does actually change the way you look at things. And some of those myths were exploded just through the works, and you can see. This is Pallavi's work on that side, and this is Sanjeev's work. He worked in the whole red light area in Bombay with the hijras. And this is an intimate image in Pallavi's aunt, actually, but she took it in her own. This is another show, Pixel Power, where I sort of wanted to look at the impact of pulp fiction and comic books on fine art. So these two spaces they were certainly divided earlier, and now there are a lot of artists who are looking at bridging those gaps. Chitra Ganesh being one of them. She does very interesting work, explores through gender. Tushar Jog, this is very funny work. This is when the market crashed in 2008, and all the prices of the artists came down. So Unicel Man is a kind of it's a sort of left, he's very left-leaning, so he's a democratic guy who's pulling down the implying correction. And Dhruvi Acharya, she's also working with Amar Chitra Katha. She's a diaspora artist. Both Chitra and Dhruvi are diaspora, but they've moved back to India. And this happened after 9/11, actually. So their work is very political, and they look at identity and all that. Sarnath, I guess, all you guys know. He's fun-loving. Then just... Thank you.